kind of want to always take a look, make sure that you're not too close, but can we make that one? I don't think so. All right, AV, how's everybody doing? We are going to be doing some touch and goes, a little bit of flying, and apparently my initial startup.
Engine fire left. Engine fire left.
So yeah, I'm engine fire right. This is a new map, engine, so I decided I'd do right. A different map today.
APU fire.
There's some more touch and goes.
APU fire. Bleed air left. Bleed air
maybe
left.
Low level flying.
Bleed air right. Bleed air right.
Unlike the last video where I was having a bunch of issues that I figured out. Apparently, it does help if you turn your APU off, which is what I did not do.
Engine fire
so that'll
left.
Cause,
engine
apparently,
fire left.
The landing gear to
engine
act as
fire
though
right.
It's they're not
engine
up.
Engine fire right.
So,
APU
which is
fire.
Interesting.
APU fire. Bleed air left. Bleed air left. Bleed air right. Bleed air right.
All right. Gone through that. Turn our radar on, our INS. Wait for this to fully spin up. Do we have green light? Green light. Let us turn engine on. We'll do the left engine first. Oh, sorry. Right engine. Probably have that mapped out. Didn't really pay attention. Alright. That spin up. Close our canopy a little here. Gonna get loud. Alright.
Roll left, roll left.
I don't want to roll left.
Flight controls. Flight controls.
Alright. Let's do the left engine. While that's doing that, let's turn our formation lights on. Pull out our probe. Oops. Wrong way. That's a. Don't have a plane captain out here to tell me if my hooks are retracted or not. Let's move that out of the way. Let's turn that on. ECM is on. Alright, get that up. Once that's up, we're gonna cycle through our bleed air, which should clear our bleed air, left and right bleed airs here, so that'll clear that. As soon as down here, let's check it out. Where's it at? All right, that clears those. Let's clear the other air bolts we have. All right, let's do an FCS bit. Oh, hold on. There it goes. That's going in the bit. Turn our HMD on so that can do that. Typically we go through a normal testing on other stuff, but not going to do that. Let's retract. Half flaps. Let's do these are PBIC go. All right, we got go. Set our flaps. Turn our aux on because I did not turn that up. Alright, I need to turn on my tac am. Let the x-rays already set. Not going to turn it on though. Don't know why I keep forgetting to do this. We are at 92. All right, let's see here. Those are on, those are on. Let's check our bits real quick. Bit page. Weapons degrade. I haven't gone through that portion yet. That. That in the manual one. The HUD mode. Oh, we'll do a displays bit. So I have this actually set up for like dynamic weather, but we are in the Persian Gulf, so if you look over there you can see Dubai, which we may fly by. Well, we're going to fly by it, but not going MDs and test. All right, we're doing our test. All right, let request taxi. Check. check our stuff first. O-blocks is on. APU is off. Let's check our... make sure that our flight controls are set properly. We're set at 12. And check our stores. So we got a couple AIM-9Xs on here. We have 3 fuel, 578 rounds. And we're carrying a few AIM-120s, so. What do I want? I want a checklist again, right? Oh, a checklist. I can read, I promise. Alright, so we have controls, wings, trim, flaps, hook, harness. Alright, harness is done. Seat is armed. Oh, we can check our warning lights real quick. Oh yeah, that looks good. Oh, this did not set this. And hydraulic pressure. Okay, all right, everything looks semi good. All right. Let's request taxi.
Colt 1-1. Request taxi to runway. Colt 1-1. Clear to taxi to runway 27.
So we have a little bit of a taxi go down here. I have to remember to turn nose wheel steering off when I go to take off. I may have my rudder pedals a little bit too touchy. So flaps are set, trim is set, things. Or let's make sure flaps are set. Okay, we're at half flaps. I may have to go to full flaps because I do have pretty heavy load going on. I have 3 external fuel tanks. Relatively heavy air-to-air load. We are in the Persian Gulf right now, so if we do happen to run into any hostiles, we'll have to figure out what we're going to do. Like I said, I do have the nose wheel steering kind of set a little, or not nose wheel, the rudder pedal set a little bit, maybe too aggressive. Something I have to get used to. I'll have to adjust again, maybe. This is usually the map I do. practice some air-to-air stuff. I do not have that set up on here right now. I have to work with that because I can see that they are relatively pretty sensitive, especially on the ground. It's probably not so much in the air, but well, maybe they are. I haven't really tried it. Kind of glad everybody's going along for the ride, maybe. See, I got a pretty good pretty heavy load here, so this ought to be interesting taking off. I haven't actually don't recall ever doing it. Might be an easier turn in here. Okay, we'll stop right here. Look to make sure we have nothing coming in. I don't see anything there. Nothing on that. Nothing that way, so let's move on to the runway. Yeah, I know, I make this sound like it's a tutorial. Believe me, it is not a tutorial. My only thing is if you're gonna start on DCS, definitely do some reading on the aircraft you're gonna be flying. Alright, here we go. That wasn't such a graceful takeoff. Like I said, I think I have my rudder pedals entirely too sensitive. Let's get our radar up. And we need to be able to see what we're doing. I don't like the map. Oh, that's right, it's on waypoint zero. I need to go to one, huh? So we're going to go out over the Persian Gulf here a little bit, and we are going to head north. Let's bring it down because we're going to go up to about 21,000. Kind of helps if you go up to turn on your auto. Kind of interesting because I haven't flown with a full load, but I don't know what I'm going to get with that because I'm not used to it. Definitely got to go through some serious what do you call it? I'm drawing a blank, sorry. Supposed to be flying at about 21,000. Might want to go up a little. The afterburner, you can hear it. Listen to that power. 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 Got a nice, somewhat hazy, deserty day. Got a ship down there in the Gulf. Maybe I should set a bingo so I can actually be cautious of my fuel supply. Say 4,000 is pretty good, that should get us back. So there's some mountains up this way that I'd like to do some low levels through. That'll also help us burn off some of the fuel we have. And I didn't bring any bombs, so we're not going to be dropping any bombs or anything like that. We're still like 50 miles from our intended waypoint 3. Get up here, you can see quite a long ways. Let's do an outside flyby. Yeah, that engine sounds kind of cool. Our 4-bar scan. Forty's the best, huh? All right. Like I say, you're gonna have to bear with me. I'm gonna have to work with this more, and I know I should do that more offline than I am on here. But Well, these are the mountains I was thinking about doing some low levels through. You know, there's a couple canyons down here, but not really canyons. That'll help us burn off some of our fuel. I was practicing some dogfighting over here, trying to just do guns and whatnot, and let's just say that some things are, it's nice to be able to bring your opponent, your bogey, or the guy that ends up on my tail all the time, make him do some quick low-level stuff and see if I can shake him a little. Gets the heart pumping a little bit, though. I know it's not real, but... And I can imagine this in, like, an actual flight sim. Trying to bleed off some airspeed. Now let's go have some fun. Now, mind you, when I've done some of these runs in here, I did not have a full load of everything, so this is going to be kind of interesting. I may crash. I hope not. See if we can go up over this one. All right, hard bank. kind of want to always take a look, make sure that you're not too close, but can we make that one? I don't think so. Yeah, but we burned a lot of fuel up. All right, let's head back to waypoint 3. Actually, let's that was kind of fun. Now let's just move this on to 4. All right, so we are going to do a straight back, and we'll do a fly-in. Sorry, I'm bouncing all over the place. Short little run. I was hoping to see some civilian aircraft, but apparently I'm not seeing anything. Maybe I forgot to put them on. Now I kind of know that I'm headed back, and I'm running at about 21,000. So I'm going to start doing a descend. About 6,000 is kind of what I want. Made a relatively you could say an easy flight pattern. Just for more touch and goes and practice on that. Plus it gives me a little bit of practice with landing with fuel tanks. Granted, if I was in a dogfight scenario or whatever, I wouldn't be coming back with all these weapons, so I'm relatively a fully loaded aircraft. So coming in is going to be a little bit different. Still got about 10,000 feet to go. I need to drop my nose a little bit more. I apologize, my eyes dart all over the place. This is kind of my little training scenarios that I do. I do a little bit of this until I kind of get bored of it. And then I'll jump into some dog fighting so I can practice basic combat maneuvering and whatnot. I am by no means an expert at this. It does take a lot of practice to manage your maneuverability, learn what other plane is doing, pay attention to your altitude and your airspeed so your energy is proper. And, I mean, it's all about physics and then survivability. And it's kind of weird because when you really think about it, because you're traveling at whatever airspeed you're doing, or in a combat scenario, you tend to you think like in a firefight, there's a lot going on when you're inside an airplane. So it's kind of like the same thing. It's the only difference is you don't have, as long as you're maintaining your ground, your situational awareness to the ground and what's going on. And utilize, that's the other thing, is I've been learning to utilize my my ability to see where I'm at, and if I'm in a situation where, if I'm in a guns on guns, basically, I'm going to try to use the mountains if I have mountains. I'm going to see if I can drag him into a mountain, and hopefully I don't hit one, or force an overshoot. Now I dipped my nose quite a bit on that one. But I want to get down to about 6,000 feet. I do have 37 miles. I could be higher up, but I'd like to be, give myself enough time to kind of, I can kind of see the runway straight ahead, even though it's 30 some miles away. It's, looks to be straight ahead for me, so zoom in. That's the airbase right there, so. I have time now to kind of line up, get all squared away. It's going to be interesting because I do have stores on here. I could jettison them, but I'm going to leave them on. Not about wasting taxpayers' dollars. Not real taxpayers' dollars, but come on. Gotta kind of live it up a little bit, right? Flying a little slow. Guess we'll turn on our tack and myself at half flaps at this point. As soon as we get down below 250, I do a drop in my gear. I'm pretty much lined up on 27. Now I am a long ways out to be doing this, but I want to try and stabilize everything, because I also, like I said, I'm using rudders and whatnot. have to maintain a little bit of airspeed because I am kind of heavy. So I want to maintain a little better airspeed for glide. Difficult when you can't actually look around the cockpit as much as you'd like. I'm still 6 miles out and I'm at 2,000 feet. Actually at 1,400. So I'd like to get a little bit higher here. Trying to keep that right there. I think we got a pretty good guide slope going on. They got 7,000 pounds of fuel. Now, I'm not doing it like the Navy does it, or we do a fly over the airfield and then come in for our landing, because I'm going to do a touch and go, come back around, as long as I don't screw up this landing. I think we got a pretty good glide slope here. Trying to get that center all lined up. Not too bad. Now, let's see how well we do going this direction. Don't want to go too high. Not too bad, maintaining about 900. The end of the runway. Mind you, I don't think any airplanes will be doing touch and goes with when they're fully loaded like this. But I'm gonna call it good practice. I'm ballooning because I had way too much airspeed going. Bringing it back around. Not too bad. A lot better than I have done. Try to aim for that one spot right there. Well, not a bad, over in case somebody else is coming in. We'll turn off here on D. Of course, I do not remember where we parked, so I am going to go this direction. Park right over here. They're probably right over there, but I don't take off from here that often. Usually landing, and there's other aircraft here. Like I said, I need to get my knee boards working. we'll unarm our seat. Turn off our INS, turn off our radar. Pull the parking brake. Alright. That's all off. Right engine off. Left engine off. Alright, everything else off. Batteries. Well, that's it. A little better than the last time. Well, thank you all for joining me on this short excursion. Maybe I'll do a dogfight one with guns and or sidewinders. So, see you in the next video. See ya.